अस्सलाम वालेकुम माय डियर स्टूडेंट, टुडे वी विल टॉक अबाउट द कॉन्फिडेंस इंटरवल फॉर पॉपुलेशन प्रोपोर्शन फॉर वन पॉपुलेशन प्रोपोर्शन। नाउ द फार्मूला फॉर दिस वन इज पी कैप, इट इज सैंपल प्रोपोर्शन प्लस माइनस जेड अल्फा बाय टू, पी कैप क्यू कैप डिवाइडेड बाय एन इन द स्क्वायर रूट। व्हाट इज पी कैप? पी कैप इज इक्वल टू एक्स ओवर एन, एक्स रिप्रेजेंट हियर द सक्सेस नंबर ऑफ सक्सेसेस एंड एन इज द सैंपल साइज, क्यू कैप इट इज 1 माइनस पी कैप। वी अप्लाइंग दिस फार्मूला। नाउ द क्वेश्चन अबाउट द सैंपल कॉन्फिडेंस इंटरवल फॉर पॉपुलेशन प्रोपोर्शन। इन अ रैंडम सैंपल ऑफ साइज एन इज इक्वल टू 250 हाउसेस इन अ हैदराबाद सिटी, इट इज फाउंड दैट 80 हाउसेस ओन कलर टीवी सेट्स, फाइंड अ कॉन्फिडेंस इंटरवल फॉर द फ्रैक्शन ऑफ होम इन दिस सिटी दैट हैव कलर सेट्स। So which things are given you? First we write here 250 means the sample size. What is x? X is equals to 80 homes own color TV. So it means it is success. Own color TV sets. So what is P cap? P cap is equals to x over n, so 80 over 250. Applying calculator, it is 0.32. What is Q cap? Q cap is equals to 1 minus P cap. It means 1 minus 0.32. It is 0.68. So we have determined P cap and Q cap. It means sample proportion. Then we are applying the formula and Z alpha by 2. It is at 90. Find a confidence interval at 95%. At 95%. Removed. Find a confidence interval. At 95% for the fraction of homes. So it means Z alpha by 2, it means 95, it means 0.025. This value is 1.96. These values are constant at Z alpha by 2 at 95%. So applying formula student. For the proportion, applying formula for the confidence interval of confidence interval for P, it means population proportion. So we write in this form P cap minus Z alpha by 2 P cap Q cap over root N P less than P cap plus Z alpha by 2 U cap Q cap over upon N. So it means find the confidence. We put all these values. It is 0.32 minus Z alpha by 2, it is 1.96. P cap it is 0.32, 0.68. Sample size it is 250. Similarly, on the right hand side, and we put here all these values 0.32, 0.68, whole upon root n, it is 250. After that, distance, when we applying the calculator and find the result with the help of calculator, 0.26 p, it is 0.38. The population proportion it is 0.262, 0.38. We find the confidence interval. For the next topic, student, find the standard error of the sample proportion. when you have given the proportion, population proportion, it is 0.50, and the sample size it is 30, and in the second part n is equals to 50, sample size is 50, but the population proportion it is 0.80. Now the formula of standard error of proportion, p cap, which is equals to p into 1 minus p over n. So if we apply the first part, you find the standard error of population sample proportion, it is p is 0.50, 1 minus 0.50, sample size is 30 in the first part, and we find the answer with the help of calculator, it is 0.09 into 100. If you multiplying by 100, it means 9%. Standard error is minimum. So for the second part, if the sample size is large, 0.20, 1 minus 0.20 whole divided by sample size is 50, applying the calculator strength, it is 0.056. if multiplying by 100, it means 5%. It means when the sample size is large, then the standard error of it will be minimized when we compare both of the results. So that's why. For the next application about strength, determination of the sample size n for mean, n is equal to z alpha by 2 into sigma over root n, sigma over n whole square. How large a sample is selected? If it is desired to be 96% confidence that the sample mean will be within 10 units of the true population when sigma is 40. So it means first we write the data. What is n? So the error it is equals to, and z alpha by 2 at 96%, the value with the help of z table, this one it is 2.06. What is sigma? Sigma is 40. And what is E? E is 10 units. Means error is 10. So all these values, we applying the formula, N is equals to Z alpha by 2 into sigma whole upon N in the square root whole upon E of whole square. So when we put all these values, you can find the result 2.02 into sigma is 40 divided by 10 whole square. What is the sample size? It means the sample size is 68. It means when sigma is 40, error is controllable error, it is 10. Sigma is 40, so it means the sample size it should be 68. So the next problem about the determination of sample size for size n for population proportion. So determination of sample size n for proportion, it is n is equals to z square alpha by 2 p into 1 minus p over p square. The question is, a few years ago, 90% of those who needed glasses were filled with contact lenses. It is suspected that the population is increased. Student, determination the percent now with an error less than 4% and the confidence interval is 95%. So which things you have given in this question? So what is E is 4%, it means 0.04, the value of E, and Z alpha by 2, it is at 95%, it is 1.96. And the sample size, it is, we have determined in this question. Now, what is P? Proportion, it is 0.3, I think. Here, student, we will do 0.3 is the proportion, say. So it means what is 1 minus P? It means 1 minus P, it is 1 minus 0.3, it is 0.7. P is unknown in this form, but we suppose here. So the sample size for the population proportion, it is Z square alpha by 2, P into 1 minus P, whole divided by E square. So we applying this formula and put all these values. Z square means 1.96 square. P is 0.3 into 0.7. What is E? E is 0.04 whole square. Applying calculator strength and find the result. The sample size, it is 504. It's a large sample. So in this lecture, student, we have discussed about the population confidence interval for population proportion and determination of sample size n for population mean and population proportion. So thank you very much. I have completed my lecture. I hope you will learn about this lecture. Take care. God bless you. Allah Hafiz.